Good morning, I'm David Bragdon. There are a lot of exciting things coming up this summer. A new pinball parlor will be opening in Portland, and at some point, somebody's going to push a large roller skate into the Willamette River. That's coming up next on Outlook Portland on Portland CW.
It's Outlook Portland, a public affairs program from Portland CW tackling current issues that affect Portland and its surrounding communities. Let's go to the main studio in Portland CW and find out what topics will be discussed on today's show.
Good morning and welcome to Outlook Portland. I'm your host, David Bragdon. And 2 weeks ago, I had the manager and owner of the Portland Beavers on the show, and they promptly went out and then lost about five games in a row. And so we're going to try to break that jinx here today. We've got two of the most accomplished athletes and performance artists here in the city are my guests today. But the sport is no longer baseball. We're moving into pinball, demolition derby, and roller derby, as well as the use of the joystick. So my guests, welcome April Roccio and Jerry Ellsworth. And you're known by other names as well. Why don't you tell us what you're...
Well, in roller derby, we all seem to have alter egos. We all have a roller derby name, and it's registered with the national database within roller derby. So only one person in the nation can have that name. And I'm Tequila, and this is Rectifier.
Yeah.
And Jerry, in your real life, well, I don't know if roller derby is the real life or what's the real life, but you're an electrical engineer, and April, you're a project manager at a law firm.
Correct.
But the world knows you as part of the Rose City Rollers.
Correct.
Derby girls. That's my first question, okay? This is sort of maybe an intimate thing, but I grew up in the 60s and the 70s, and I'm not supposed to refer to women as girls. Why are we allowed to talk about derby girls?
I think a lot of people call us ladies. It depends. I don't really mind the term girl, but I think a lot of roller derby teams are called the Rat City Roller Girls or Roller Girls. We're called the Rose City Rollers, which I think we tried to maybe eliminate that girls aspect. But I personally don't have a problem with it. Ladies, girls, either or. I don't know about you.
Yeah, I don't have much issue with that.
All right. Great. Thank you for being so open-minded. So when you were little girls, was this something you were aspired to? You said, I'm going to grow up and be a Rose City Roller.
I don't think I ever saw roller derby when I was a kid.
I had no idea what it was, and I heard about it and didn't know that it had been a major sport or entertainment piece in the 70s. And it's probably a good thing that I didn't, because I would have been really scared to check it out.
Okay, well, let's show the viewers at home a little bit about what it is about. Okay, it wouldn't be the same if it was men, would it?
I don't think so. There are some men leagues. To be an Olympic sport, we would have to have men and women be in roller derby, and there are some male leagues around. I think it's more interesting and fun for women, but that's me. Yeah. I don't know.
What does your mom say about it?
My mom was very surprised that I got into this. I heard about it and said that I wanted to join, and she had always seen me as being kind of a girly girl and doing ballet and gymnastics and figure skating on ice skates. And when I told her I wanted to do this, she thought I was out of my mind, and still probably does when she comes and watches this. But I think that she sees that it's a really positive thing in my life and that it's a really great thing to be a part of. And she supports it.
So next Saturday night, the 14th of May, or actually it's the 17th of May,
yes.
What can fans expect? Come on out to the Expo Center.
Yeah, we have about 2,400 people that come to our bouts at the Expo Center. We have the highest ticket sales in the nation right now. And it will be a big lights, camera, action, sporting slash entertainment event for all ages. And we have four teams that are playing. The Heartless Heathers are playing Northern California, NorCal. And then we have the other two teams of the league, the High Rollers and the Guns N' Rollers playing.
So is it showbiz or is it sports?
I think there's a lot of sports aspects to it. I mean, we're out practicing 4 and 5 times a week, and a lot of endurance practice, and there's actually skill involved. It's a little confusing for the first-time viewer of like what the rules are, but there are rules
now,
we play.
Now, there are a lot of referees.
Yeah.
The ratio of players to referees got to be higher than any other sport I've ever seen. What is that about?
There's line refs to make sure that you're not going outside of the track. There's people watching how you're hitting, how you're passing other people. There's just so many rules, I think, to watch out for.
Yeah, there's a lot of like sneaky stuff going on.
Yeah,
sometimes, get an extra
are
little
you,
jab.
Are either of you sneaky?
Sometimes. No, not at all.
You ever get in the penalty box?
I almost got ejected from a game for hitting someone after the game had ended.
What, you hit somebody after the game had ended?
Yeah, I was a little naughty.
What did you do?
They were hitting one of my players, and I didn't think that was right, so I came flying out of the penalty box and knocked him to the ground.
And so what's the punishment for that?
Well, I got a scolding, and then this other person I hit down really wasn't very nice to me the rest of the time.
Well, you have a lot of fans. Do you have any stalkers? I mean, besides me, do you have other stalkers besides me?
Yeah, besides you, I've had one that kind of sent a lot of flowers and things and strange letters and whatnot, and I just tried not to respond to those. But it was flattering, and I got some good wine out of it.
Good, as long as you get something.
Nice. Yeah, I've had some stalkers, but not associated with roller derby. I happen to be, in the New York Times at one point, and I had like hundreds of emails coming in, and people actually found my father's phone number and started calling my father and asking whether I was single and mailing me things to my house. And
it's a dangerous world out there. Well,
it's pretty
seriously, I mean, you have a lot of great followers. I mean, it's an exciting and very diverse crowd out there. And when we come back after this break, I want to talk a little bit about the other part of your career that got you in the New York Times, a different part of your life. But we're going to need to take a break here for a commercial, and then we'll come back after that here on Outlook Portland.
Outlook Portland will continue in a moment.